going to talk about some stretches you can do to help you sit longer cross-legged. Okay, so the first one is called the pigeon stretch, and this is for the external rotators of the hip. So when you're sitting cross-legged, for some people the main restrictor of that motion is the hips, and they start to get pain in the hip area and the lower back area. So in order to release that area off, we can do the pigeon stretch. And you should do these stretches every day until you notice your mobility improve, and then you want to still do them every day to maintain the benefits. So we have our knee in an L kind of shape here, at 90 degree angle. And then I'm going to bring the other leg straight back behind me. And keeping this at a 90 degree angle, I'm going to lean into my knee. So going straight over my leg, so I should feel a stretch along the hip here. I'm going to hold that stretch for 30 seconds and then repeat on both sides. Next stretch is for the internal rotators, so the muscles on the other side of the hip, which again are very important, because what tends to happen is you should have 45 degrees internal rotation and 45 degrees in the other direction. Because if you sit cross-legged for a long period of time, you get very good internal rotators, but you get an imbalance on the other side, so you want to make sure the other side is balanced. That will reduce the strain. So you can see there, I don't have as much getting out as I do going in, so it should be equal. So in order to balance that out, I can do this exercise. So now, leg in the L direction again, but in the opposite direction. So instead of foot facing in, foot facing out, this knee is, foot is just there for support, and I'm going to lean back. Now, I should feel a stretch on this side of the hip. And if that's easy, then you can go back further and you can lie flat on your back. I can do that, but my knee raises up, so just to show you. See, ideally I want that knee to stay flat and flush with the ground. So if it's coming up, then my hip's not quite mobile enough to do that stretch yet. So that's the second stretch for the internal rotators. And the last one is called the pike. So what you do is feet straight, and then trying to keep your back relatively straight. You want to try and lean forward as far as you can, and this opens up the hamstrings and your lower back, so your posterior chain muscles. So leaning forward, deep breath in after 10 seconds. Breathe out and go a bit further. Hold for 10 seconds, deep breath in. Breathe out. A bit further. You can do this pre or post sitting cross-legged, and it's going to help relieve some of the tension and the pain in the area. Last one, just as a extra bonus, is the groin. So some people, especially people with a larger frame, they tend to not be able to get their knees down because they have a very tight groin. And for that, general groin stretch, feet together, so palms of the feet together, push down with your elbows, hold that for 10 seconds, bring it up slightly, and then go down a bit further. I'm going to repeat that again, holding that stretch for 30 seconds.